everybody.
Say amen.
God
has spoken.
So let the church.
Say amen.
Yeah. Welcome to Canaan Baptist Church Wednesday night service. Glad to have all of you in Zoom and with other technologies that you are on. I hope you enjoy the service. Let us pray. Our Father and our God, we come to you. Say thank you. Thank you for your grace. Thank you for your mercy. We thank everyone who is out in Zoom. We ask, Lord, that everyone be blessed with a fair portion of health. We ask comfort for those who are grieving. We ask for mental illness to be addressed. We ask for crime to stop. We ask that our children adapt to their new world and let them have their activities and their friends back. Father God, we ask you to bless the parents and the teachers, the essential workers of all services. Lord God, we are in a war brought on by one person. And we ask you, Lord, to bless that person. Give them a new heart and let them turn things around. Father God, keep us from worry and upset about the economy. Lord, I ask all of these things in your name. Amen. Thank you. Our scripture for this evening comes from Philippians 4:9. Whatever you have learned or received from me or seen in me, put it into practice, and the God of peace will be with you. Amen. Our Father and our God, I ask you to hide me behind you, and let the words of my mouth be from you. This I pray. Amen.
Good evening for your Wednesday night's announcements. Pastor Johnson announced on Sunday, Canaan will be joining and assisting the people of Ukraine as millions continue to flee the country during their conflict with Russia. Canaan will receive dry goods at the church. A box located in the lobby is designated for donations. For additional information, you can contact me at david.brown@canaanbaptist.nyc.com. This year, Canaan proudly celebrates our 90th anniversary. United we stand, together we can, is our theme. Join Chair Shaniqua Green and Co-Chair Timothy Adams and their committee for a year-long milestone celebration that has not only embraced the past, takes a joyful leap into the future. Sunday, May 15th, is Anniversary Sunday. Stay connected on our social media sites to learn about all the upcoming events. Ladies, there are some tickets still available for Saturday, March 19th, Women's Empowerment Luncheon, What's in My Bag, Mental Health, From Silence to Solutions, Women's Finding Their True Personalities. The event will bring awareness to health and social issues that have affected women often negatively since the pandemic. There are incredible motivational speakers, starting with scheduled Linda Starks, First Lady of the Fresh Start New Beginnings Christian Church, and Ebony M. Carrington, Managing Director of Manhattan Health Strategies. For information or tickets, please see Marshall E. Watson or any one of the Women of Canaan Cares. Spring Revival and Spring Anniversary of Ministries begins Sunday, March 25th at 10 a.m. and continues Monday and Wednesday at 7 p.m. This year's theme is God Still on the Throne, with supporting scripture from Philippians chapter 2, verse 10 and 11. The revival celebrant is Reverend Aiken O. Ryle, the Eastern Regional Vice President at the large of the Progressive National Baptist Convention. Please come out and support our revival. The MTA is desperately looking to hire bus drivers. The current application period is open from now until March 31st, with an expected test date of April 18th. Additional dates are scheduled in May, June, July, and in August. For information or to get a test application, you may go to new.mta.info/document/78066. Get your taxes prepared for free at the Harlem Children's Zone's Community Pride Program. Preparers will also help you find out if you qualify for the Earned Income Tax Credit or the Child Tax Credit. This is a free assistance program which is available until April 18th. For information, you can call 212-932-1920 or you can email taxes@hcz.org. The Brothers of Alpha Phi Alpha Fraternity, INC, are inviting graduate African-American males attending high school in Essex County, New Jersey, to apply for the Marion B. Frederick Scholarship. This scholarship will be a reward of $2,000. An application must be completed along with a transcript and a letter of recommendation. The application deadline is Thursday, March 31st, 2022, at exactly 11:59 p.m. For information, please contact Dr. Brian D. Agnew, Scholarship Chair at scholarship@theaalfoundation.org. With Palm Sunday and Easter approaching, there is no better way for you to join one of our weekly Bible studies or our worship services. Bible Colloquium continues Monday evenings with the Reverend Dr. Greg B. Jones. You can join him on Zoom at 6:30 when he will continue to teach about Atmos Amos, one of the minor prophets. Wednesday afternoons at 1 p.m., join while with Reverend Marshall Lee Watson at 1 p.m. on Zoom. This Wednesday night service, the Reverend Dr. Travis Boyd will bring the word. He will be heard here at 7 p.m. at the church's Facebook or YouTube channels at Canaan Baptist COC. Our senior pastor also joined his Bible study classes on Thursday at 6:30. This is Pastor Johnson's, where he will be teaching from Galatians. Join him Thursdays on Zoom as well. We thank you to bring your attention to these announcements. Enjoy your night.
Thank you. The name of my sermon is The Peace of God. Scripture is Philippians 4:9. It reads thus, "Whatever you have learned or received from me or seen in me, put into practice, and the God of peace will be with you." The meaning of peace: freedom from disturbance or hostility, to be complete, whole, to live well. The Bible tells us that peace is more than just the absence of conflict. It is taking action to restore a broken situation. It is more than a state of tranquility. It is a state of wholeness and completeness. God is the source of peace, and one of his names is Yahweh Shalom, which means the Lord is peace. From Judges 6:24. When we consider the nature of Jesus and his qualities that are divine, they are divine and human. Long before his birth, the prophet Isaiah declared of him who was to come. For unto us a child is born. Unto us a son is subsequently given. His name will be called Wonderful, Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. Of the increase of his government of peace, there will be no end. Subsequently, spiritual darkness was really caused by sin. God promised to send a light that would shine on everyone living under the shadow of his spiritual death. In 722 BC, the Assyrians conquered the northern kingdom of Israel, scattering the 10 tribes that lived throughout the Assyrian Empire. These tribes became known as the Lost Tribes of Israel. 20 years later, Assyria conquered Judah. They deported many of the Jews to Assyrian territories. Amidst this social and political turmoil came the prophet Isaiah. His ministry lasted 50 years, in which he called the people to repent for seeing the scattering of the Jews because of their sins. Isaiah prophesied the birth of Jesus. Isaiah 7:14 says, "Therefore the Lord shall give you a sign. Behold, a virgin shall conceive and bear a son, and shall call him Emmanuel. Unto us a child is given, a son is born." He also prophesied Jesus' ministry in chapter 61. "The Spirit of the Lord of God is upon me. The Lord has anointed me to preach good tidings to the poor. He has sent me to heal the brokenhearted and proclaim liberty to the captives." Isaiah prophesies the suffering of Jesus. Chapter 53, "He was wounded for our transgressions. The chastisement of our peace was upon him, and with his stripes we are healed." He served as spiritual advisor to four kings: Uzziah, Jotham, Ahaz, Hezekiah. Isaiah is called the Messiah prophet because he spoke of end times, tribulations, and the future of Israel more than any other prophet. Isaiah prophesied the coming Messiah would be known by many titles. Jesus would be called Wonderful, Counselor, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace, because through his birth and life, God would establish an eternal kingdom to deliver his people from tyranny and slavery of sin. The government that Christ established is spiritual, where God rules within the hearts of people, just like Joseph was the chief administrator of Pharaoh's kingdom. Jesus Christ is the administrator of God's kingdom. Not that times have really changed. Jesus remains our peace amid chaos, disorder, and confusion. God knows we live in the same time. 1 Corinthians 14:43 reminds us that God is not the author of confusion, but of peace. The quality of God is order and clarity. Chaos does not originate with God. The Hebrew word for peace is shalom, meaning God's rule and justice. While we work, pray, advocate, and politic for a better world and a better government in the United States, we must keep in mind that God's government is not of this world, because is not his kingdom, because he is not of this world. Amid national and international mayhem and chaos, Isaiah affirmed to God's people that God is the creator and sustainer of life of the universe and remains in control despite the appearance that the enemy has the upper hand. The kingdom of God and his Christ is spiritual, and it lives within our hearts. Jesus himself said, "My kingdom is not of this world. The kingdom of God is within you. Seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things shall be added unto you." We have a host of earthly leaders in high places, but their kingdoms are floored and will rise and fall. But God's kingdom is eternal and is from everlasting to everlasting. And so the transformation of earthly kingdoms, meaning the government, comes only as there is spiritual transformation in the lives of those who lead our nations and through those who are citizens of God's kingdom. There is spiritual peace in God's kingdom, but that peace cannot be experienced by anyone until Jesus Christ takes up residence in your life. When you work for God's shalom here on earth, we become peacemakers in this world in which we live. Shalom means peace. There are spiritual transformations going through each of our lives right now. First, we had the pandemic, which lasted 2 long years. People lost loved ones and jobs. And we are not quite out of it yet, but we are getting there. We have food insecurity, and that is ongoing. The economy took a downward spiral during the pandemic, and it is going to get worse before it gets better. Prices are going up in every area. Medicine is going through the ceiling, and health care, of course, keep rising. Brethren, remain in prayer. Don't let your heart be discouraged. Stay in the Word. Don't worry, because it won't help. Instead, meditate and trust in God. God promised to supply all your needs, not some, but all. John 3:16 says that God promised never to leave or forsake you. Maybe that is why the apostle writes in Colossians 3:15, "Let the peace of Christ rule in your hearts, since as members of one body, you were called to peace. As the Prince of Peace, Christ administers God's rule of peace. Amen. We cannot experience soul peace without first having made peace with God, meaning God in Christ desires to sit where Jesus is up in his kingdom and rule in our hearts. Jesus is not just our Savior. He is our Lord as well. Finding a vaccine for the coronavirus, restoring our economy, bringing back jobs and employment opportunities, addressing our deep-seated issues, crime, racial tensions, providing affordable health care are all needed, but they remain exterior to the soul. They can only be received through a relationship with God, the Messiah, proclaimed the prophet Isaiah. Praying and working for a more bipartisan Congress that works together is not in gridlock. Are needed, but they cannot guarantee there will be peace in the city, because the peace Christ gives is a peace that is not of this world. We can work to accomplish all of this, but without God in Christ ruling the inner heart, there can be no true spiritual nor soul peace from within. We see these examples can make for world peace. It will still leave a lot to be desired because they work from the outside in. And personal transformation and conversion never happen from the outside in, but from the inside out. It works because the Prince of Peace has come to take up residence in your heart. Jesus is the Prince of Peace. Ephesians 2:14 declares that he is our peace. Soul peace is not just found in positive thinking, as much as this may be a benefit. Soul peace is not found in the absence of conflict or problems as much as we would like to live without problems and conflict. Soul peace is not found in good feelings, good health, money in the bank. To some degree, this would give us a peace of mind, but soul peace comes directly from Christ ruling our hearts. Amen. We can all have forms of peace the world offers us and still need soul peace. In John 14:27, Jesus gives us the promise to his disciples and us that he is giving us a peace and leaving us a peace that the world cannot give. Only you can experience this peace. Peace is beyond true description. If one was to try and give a description of peace, they might say, the Holy Spirit comes down to indwell in the believer, and the Spirit can insulate our hearts. The deeper inner sanctum of our souls with the peace of Christ in such a way that the forces of sin, uncertainty, fear, doubt, and many other hostile forces cannot overcome. The peace of Christ enables us to weather disturbing circumstances and uncertainties. Jesus promised us in John 14 that the peace he gives cannot be given by anything nor anyone in the world. He reminds us that peace does not come from trouble and fear, but protects us from allowing these forces to overwhelm us. The peace he gives does not mean peace in the absence of trouble. The peace is in the midst of trouble. Peace is not from the absence of fear. Peace is in the midst of the fear. Peace, which the world offers, is peace of escape, the peace that comes from avoiding trouble, the peace based on what one possesses, not based on what one possesses financially and materially, a peace which comes from refusing to face our realities. The peace that Jesus offers is independent of outward circumstances. It is peace which no experience in life can take from us. The peace he gives is no sorrows, nor dangers, nor suffering. He is our peace, our Prince of Peace. The peace Jesus gives is not the same that the world gives. It's not bought on Wall Street, negotiated in the UN, and it cannot guarantee a thriving economy, or promise, or the promises of world leaders. Because the peace he gives is himself. It is soul peace, peace of fellowship, friendship, forgiveness, salvation, grace and mercy, and his protection. The peace that God will supply all our needs according to his riches in Jesus Christ. The peace that has gone on, he has gone on to prepare a place for us where he is. We will someday be also. The peace is when this battle is over. We shall wear a crown in New Jerusalem, soul peace. Peace is a reality that few people experience these days. But amid our chaotic world, God offers a peace that goes far beyond human understanding. This hope of peace lies at the heart of the story of the Bible. Because of Adam and Eve's rebellion in the Garden of Eden, all are born in need of a restored relationship with the Creator. God lovingly provided a solution for this problem. He promised to send someone who would offer salvation to everyone. This person is Jesus, the Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world. John 1:29, by faith we identify and trust in Jesus, offer of himself for our sins, so we can experience salvation and peace with God. Our daily events threaten peace, anger, jealousy, relationships, jobs, health issues, leaving us feeling anything but peaceful. Jesus provides the peace of God. He said, "Peace I leave with you, my peace I give you. I do not give you as the world gives. Do not let your heart be troubled, and do not be afraid." John 14:27. The Apostle Paul encouraged his readers with these words, "Let the peace of Christ rule in your hearts. Since as members of one body, you were called to peace." The big story of the Bible is that Jesus has conquered death and promises us an eternal life. Because of this wonderful truth, we don't need to be consumed by the world's uncertainty. Instead, we can let the peace of God rule in our hearts. Every morning, pray for a peaceful day. Peace resides within you. This is not always easy, because some days, life changes it, will rob you of that peace. You will have to rely on your patience, be kind, be slow to anger, be steadfast, and love. Love is the most important of all things. Use these tools from the fruits of the Spirit to quiet you from impatience, anger, anxiety, and worry. Remember, trouble doesn't last always. These are tests and tribulations. They will empower you. You will be a better, stronger, and wiser person. God's peace comes to us when our minds are steadfast. In Hebrew, the word steadfast means to lean on. When we lean on Him, we will experience His calming presence. God will humble the proud and the wicked and smooth the path for those who love Him. God's peace is a profound sense of security, even in distress. It's a peace that surpasses human understanding and guards our hearts and minds amid the most difficult of circumstances. Philippians 4, 6, 7. Let us pray. Father, help us to trust You and have a steadfast mind. Thank You for the perfect peace that comes to us when we choose to trust You. Amen. To join us here at Canaan Baptist Church of Christ. Come and give God your heart and make Him your personal Savior. Those watching on social media can call this number, 212-866-0301, when the church opens at 9 a.m. You can also get us by typing in Canaan Baptist Church, COC, at gmail.com. To him be the glory. May the grace of Jesus Christ be with your spirit. May peace reign. May peace and dominion reign over you. For now and forevermore, amen, amen, and amen. Good night.